Hello! Good morning! Halika! Magkape muna tayo. Welcome to our morning coffee with Father Jerry. Our text for our reflection today comes from Luke chapter 6, verses 43 to 49. It says, "No good tree bears bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. Each tree is recognized by its own fruit. People do not pick figs from thorn bushes or grapes from briars. A good man brings good things out of the good stored up in his heart, and an evil man brings evil things out of the evil stored up in his heart. For the mouth speaks what the heart is full of. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do what I say? As for everyone who comes to me and hears my words and puts them into practice, I will show you what they are like. They are like a man building a house who dug down deep and laid the foundation on a rock. When a flood came, the torrent struck that house but could not shake it because it was well built. But the one who hears my words and does not put them into practice is like a man who built a house on the ground without a foundation. The moment the torrent struck to that house, it collapsed and its destruction was complete." Thus far is the reading for today from the Gospel of St. Luke. We ask ourselves, what is it for us? What is God's message for us based on the gospel text just read? For our backgrounder in the gospel today, ito yung part sa gospel ni Saint Luke na if you thoroughly read it, you will realize that it seems there's such a kind of disconnectedness or a disconnection between those thoughts or words he expressed in his text today. Reason is, itong particular text from Luke, ito yung compilation niya. Compilation sa iba't ibang mga sayings, quotations, teachings of Jesus that was said, preached, done in several occasions while he was in the ministerial life as a preacher. So, ang pagkasulat ni Saint Luke, it seems ang dating para siyang one-time shot, only one-time shot recording of one occasion or one event. Pero actually, hindi. Ito yung compilation niya na ang mga sinusulat niya, it seems that it appears it happened on a one setting or one event, but actually, no. it is the different teachings, sayings of the Lord on several occasions na kinumpile ni Luke and written in particular, and that's the gospel today. Kailangan lang nating malalaman, at of course it's important to know its particular background of this text written for our reflection every day. So yun yung background niya. That's why sabi ko, if you just read it through and through, wala lang, okay lang. But if you are really serious analyzing all those texts, you will realize that there is some disconnections among the statements written by Luke, because yun ang reason. It is written in different occasions, compiled into one, and it seems ang dating sa atin, yun, statements of the Lord on one occasion. Actually, it's not. Okay? According to William Barclay, actually, sabi niya, itong particular text ni St. Luke, ito yung mga lessons, teachings, na naging last part ng kanyang Sermon on the Mount. Sermon on the Mount by an account written by Matthew on the Mount. Pero pagdating sa writings ni Luke, it's not actually on the Mount. It's on the plain. While Jesus coming from the Mount, going down to the plain, level ground, ibig sabihin ng plain. And then there, Jesus was talking about the 8 blessings or the 8 beatitudes. And this particular gospel today, ito yung last part ng kanyang teachings on the 8 blessedness or the 8 beatitudes. That's why kung napansin nyo, it focuses on it pictures out a life na naging bunga siya. Bunga sa anong binibuild mo in your life before. So, yan ang bunga ngayon nakatutok dito. That's why he was speaking about trees na walang tree o kahoy na walang masamang kahoy na mag-produce ng hindi magandang bunga. So, ibig sabihin, kung maganda yung growth process ng isang kahoy, so, obviously, maganda rin ang bunga ng kahoy na yon. And tuloy-tuloy yung mga sinasabi niya and so on. And then, I would like to apply it into ourselves. Then, ito nga ang tanong natin, what is it for us? What is God's message for us today? I was still in college. Hindi ko makalimutan ito. Until now, itong mga different quotations or sayings ng aking mga professor noon. For example, when I was in college, isa sa mga professors ko sa English literature, I don't know, sa classroom, sa sermon, sa chapel, lagi niyang inuulit-ulit ito. At hindi ko sila iintindihan that time. Ang lagi niyang quotation or statement ay ganito, "What you are is what you will be." Kahit nagagalit yan sa amin, lagi niyang inuulit yon, ginagawa niyang conclusion, "What you are now is what you will be." Tawa lang kami ng tawa, tawa rin ako ng tawa. Hindi ko siya na iintindihan that time. Can you imagine 35 years na ako sa pagkapare, just lately ko na lang siya na iintindihan. Ano bang ibig sabihin na to? What you are today is what you will be. What you are is what you will be. And then another quotations then, sabi ng ibang mga narinig ko mga quotations before sinulat ko. What you are outside is what you are inside. Huh? what you are outside is what you are inside. I would like to connect these two quotations in relation to the gospel message, at the same time challenge rin sa atin. Totoo nga yung sinasabi ni Jesus. Kung maganda ang puno, of course, maganda ang bunga. If you want to know what kind of tree that produces this particular fruit na napakagandang bunga o fruit na to, obviously, makikita mo yun dahil maganda yung puno mismo. At maganda yung puno dahil it was completely cultivated, cultured, talagang nurtured, kumpleto. So, ang end effect, ang end result. Remember the term? Inulit-ulit ko sa inyo yung principle of cause and effect. So, kung ang effect sa isang produkto ay very nice, ganda-ganda, dahil maganda ang pinanggalingan. So, with us in our personal or inner life. Kung ang inner life natin is properly motivated ka, I mentioned in my 15 minutes with Father Jerry before, na yung ating childhood orientation, during our childhood orientation in our family, and if everything about God, the basic catechism on God, all those teachings about God, why do we pray, why do we need to be baptized, why do we make the sign of the cross, what is it for, and so on and so forth. If all those things are already instilled into our minds during that younger age, during our orientation, of course, as you grow up to adulthood, to maturity, sigurado yun, makikita yan as bunga ng ating pinanggagalingan. Dahil instill na sa ating minds at sa ating puso ang mga bagay-bagay tungkol ni God and the ways of God and the principles of God, of course, you grow up, you flourish because you are nurtured by all the things about God. So, ibig sabihin ito, every time you talk, every time you relate with people, every time you open your mouth, every time you relate to others, it always manifests a true, authentic, mature personality of who you are inside you. Dahil kung anong nakikita natin sa labas, ito ay epekto lang kung anong meron sa loob. Sabi pa nga sa gospel ending ngayon ni Jesus, when the heart is full, the mouth speaks. Hindi talaga pwedeng hindi mag-open out ang mouth. Yun yung sinasabi kong, every blessing, every good things coming into our life, dahil good things ito, dapat hindi siya tinatago. Dahil good things ito at naging good news ito, dapat ay pinalabas at binabahagi sa ating kapwa o sa ating mga neighborhood o sa ating congregation, sa ating church. And I guess that's the challenge of Jesus today. If you are built up of the things about God with all its moral principles and values, the way you are seen today by people outside of you, you are a witness, you are a manifestation, you are a finest product of the image of God within yourself. Dahil nga sabi ni Jesus sa gospel, I think of my life as a tree and as, saan ba yun? No good tree bears bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. Each tree is recognized by its own fruit. Kung anong bunga, anong bunga nakikita sa labas ng kapwa natin, dahil ang iyong pinanggagalingan is mismo you belong to a good tree. Okay? So, paano yan, mga kapatid? Good morning ulit. And don't forget to finish your coffee. And see you tomorrow.